Hello everyone, it's Keisha Dennis here, the tax guru, tax specialist, personal CFO, notary signing agent. I do a lot of things financial, everything financial. Anyway, I thought I'd get on here for a little while to talk to you guys about how I got started in the tax industry. I had a job that was paying just about six figures, and I had done all of this college, incurred so much debt, followed the footsteps of my mom, and wanted to become a registered nurse, so I thought. But after I did all of that schooling and got into the medical field, I realized it just wasn't for me. And everyone has their niche. Yay for the nurses, we need you, we appreciate you. It just didn't happen to be the lifestyle that I wanted to live. I had five daughters at the time, and I mean, still have five daughters, of course, but I have five daughters, and it was a lot. You know, I had children at home at the time. I didn't have grown children, so it was all on me. And I know, like a lot of people, when it just feels like the only option, we roll with it. And going to work is good for a lot of people. And, you know, going to school is great for a lot of people because it did a lot for me. I'm able to network. I have business relationships with some of those college friends today. And it actually has been exponential for my company. However, I got started when I was working for a particular hospital, my dream job, or so I thought it was. And I was there like almost all day from like 9 a.m. or 8:30 a.m. until about 8:39 at night. And being away from your kids that long, for some people is great. For me, it just didn't work out. And a lady approached me and she said that I could make the same amount in the financial field doing taxes. Well, I had never done taxes before and I kind of was adamant. I decided to take a leap of faith. Majority of my jobs that I had were contract jobs, and this job was going to be coming to a close soon unless they chose to hire me, and I wasn't going to take that risk again. I was going to go for something that I was going to bet on myself because it was an investment. The lady was charging, I believe, a good amount over $1,000 to get started, and I paid it, you know, and that was the best, about $1,900, I believe it was, but that was the best $1,900 that I spent because it tapped me into a different world, and it tapped me into the world of finances. And I don't know if you guys are aware, but everything has a language, whether you're in the medical field, whether you're in the retail field, fashion field, music field, you know, whatever industry you're in, there is a language, and you must learn that language if you want to progress. So learn the language of whatever you guys are into. At that time, I didn't know financial literacy. I didn't know the language. I didn't know the lingo. I didn't know about taxes. I didn't know that when you go to work, the first 3 months that you work, you're actually working for free because you're paying taxes. So if you deduct, and I guarantee anyone who has a job, a 9-to-5, you sit down and you look at the amount that you pay in taxes for the whole entire year, and then you calculate that and you divide that into hours and see how many hours that adds up to. And when you balance it all out, it's about 3 months of your life that you spend working, paying solely into taxes. I didn't know this back then. Financial literacy was it. That was like the best language that I started learning. So when I got into the tax realm, I can say that I made almost as much as I made for the whole year in 2 months. And right then I was sold. Where most people are afraid to go, you know, to lose their job, I was afraid to go back to work. And after that, I made it my mission to teach people who were willing, and especially people who had children at home and people who were ready to buy their time back. I started teaching people how to buy their time back. And it's been the most self-fulfilling, gratifying thing that I've ever done in my life. Just teaching people things that they don't know in general is fun, because when they have those aha moments, or, you know, they realize that they can, you know, save $10,000 on their taxes, or, you know, they may not have gotten a refund, and after our tax strategies, they are able to receive a refund. And a lot of people use this money for whatever they need during the year. A lot of times people don't get lump sums of money at one time. And this is a time of the year that's kind of like Christmas for a lot of people. So with that being said, my niche now is to just continue to get the skill sets needed to build, grow, and get to the masses, to let you guys know what I learned and how I got out of my 9-to-5. And a lot of people, they that are contractors here, they still have their 9-to-5s, and they choose their hours. They don't have to report. You know, it's a different type of freedom. And understanding finances is key. I mean, it's priceless what they learn here. So I invite all of you guys to go visit www.upscaletaxprofessionals.com. Once again, that's www.upscaletaxprofessionals.com, and check us out. And if you're in the neighborhood, if you're in the area, the downtown East Bay region, downtown Oakland, we would love for you to drop by and utilize any of our services. We have so much going on. We have a lot coming up in the next tax season. There's some videos that I will be posting soon regarding different tax credits that you may be available for. I mean, not available for. Of course, we're all available for money, right? For any type of savings. But you might qualify for it. So if you want to see if you qualify for anything, or if you want to see if you're losing on your taxes, or if there's any strategies that we may be able to assist you with, you can book an appointment with us, a consultation, on www.upscaletaxprofessionals.com. Once again, this is Keisha coming to you from Upscale Tax Professionals, wishing everyone a wonderful rest of your day, and we can't wait to help you.